Father, we thank you again once more. We honor thy name, O Lord, who has gathered your church again. We pray, be thou exalted forever and ever in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As we are about to hear your word, we cover this message with the blood of Jesus Christ. We cover your children here with the blood of Jesus Christ. We cover your church worldwide with the blood of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
The topic of our message today is Jesus Christ, the true foundation. Amen.
Amen.
As we are approaching our Christmas celebration, it is important for us as well to enlighten the world the importance of Jesus into this world. Praise the living God.
Hallelujah.
The birth of Christ means a lot to every believer. Any true child of God have to value the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. Because Christ is the true foundation of our salvation. Without Christ, there won't be salvation for mankind. If you have your Bible, please, and you don't mind, please turn with me to the book of Isaiah. Chapter 28, I'm reading from verse 16. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
And he says, therefore, thus said the Lord God, behold, I lay in Zion for a foundation, a stone, a tried stone, a precious cornerstone, a sure foundation. He that believeth shall not make haste. Amen.
Amen.
And the Lord says, I have laid this foundation, a well-trusted foundation, foundation of salvation of the people of God. And whosoever that believeth and follow the will of God, and follow from this foundation, the Lord said, such person will never be put to shame. And such person shall be saved at the last day. This is the importance of Christ on earth. The birth of Christ means all for believers. Praise the living God.
Amen.
So it is important we, the believers, to understand what is Christ. His presence on earth, what does it mean to I and you? And the plan, when does this started? It started from the Most High God. Isaiah prophesied about this foundation. There is no any other foundation that anyone can lay today that will be greater than the foundation of our Lord Jesus Christ. There is not any other foundation from any other power or any other source that will be quality and everlasting as the foundation of our Lord Jesus Christ. If you don't mind, still turn with me to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, I'm reading from verse 11. And it says, for other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. And the scripture says, there is no any other foundation can be laid. There is no any other way of salvation that people will expect than this salvation that has come from our Lord Jesus Christ. And 12 proceed to say, now if any man build upon this foundation gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hair, stubble, 13. Every man's work shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. Amen.
Amen.
When we are following Christ, we have procedures. And the scripture says, our foundation has been laid by our Lord Jesus Christ. And now Christ has gathered us and assembled us as the people of God to continue from that same foundation. And the apostles of Christ, they did the same. And today, we are being expected to continue from where the apostles of Christ left over for us. And the scripture says, no matter the work you are doing in the house of God, it's highly valued. No matter the work you are doing for God, in as much as you are doing that work to promote the evangelism of our Lord Jesus Christ, He said, it is highly valid. In the house of God, we need to come together to work for God. We don't need to follow God selfishly. With whatsoever God has given you as a gift, use that for God as you are living. That is your own contribution towards this salvation. And some of us have been given gold to invest in this sure foundation. Some of us silver, some of us other precious stones. And the scripture says, but in all, we are doing this to promote the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. You don't need to desert what God has given to you. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 6, he says, St. Paul is sowing and Apollos is watering the trees. Which means the whole of us are being gifted in different areas in the house of God. When you are a singer and you rejected that gift that God has given unto you to continue praising Him, you start going into prophecy. You are making a mistake. And this is the problem we are having today in churches. When most of us, those that have been gifted to be a singer, they deserted their singing. And one of the most valuable angels in heaven are the angel of cherubim and seraphim. Those that are praising God day and night. But today, everybody, we desert what God has given to us. To start laying a foundation that is not being given to us, which we did a wrong work before God. Praise the living God. And verse 13 says, our work shall be tried. No matter whatsoever you are doing for God, it shall be tried. Don't commonize whatsoever you are doing in the name of God. The get men in the house of God will surely make the kingdom of God if they do it properly. And the prophets will make the kingdom of God as well if they do it properly. And the teachers of scripture will make the kingdom of God if they do it properly. Praise the living God.
Yeah.
And those that did not do it properly will not make the kingdom of God at the last day. This is the basic commandments of God. For we to follow up with the foundation that Christ has laid, whatsoever you are having, give that to God as you are living. Personally, to myself, I never want to be a preacher. I love being a philanthropist in the house of God. To sponsor the house of God financially, this has been my greatest dream. The time comes when Pastor Joseph Sapong, he called me and said, you are making a mistake, brother. God says you have to be a preacher. You have to be his minister. You don't have to be a philanthropist. And I argued him. Angrily, I left. And a few weeks, I start having problems that brings me back to the house of God. So therefore, you as a child of God, ask yourself a question. And in this life, what is that gift that God has given to me to exist in the house of God? And if God reveals that to you, start doing it. That is your own job in the house of God. To support the presence of Christ on earth. Because the scripture says this is a sure foundation. That not any other foundation can be valid more than the foundation that Christ has laid for the children of God. Praise and thank God.
Amen.
And verse 14 says, if any man's work abide, which he has built up thereupon, he shall receive a reward. Praise and thank God.
Amen.
Whatsoever you have done in the name of God, Christ says, there is a reward at the last day. Even from this earth, while you are living. So when we keep struggling and puzzling in the house of God over power, it is highly prohibited. In the days of the apostles, some of them are preachers. Some of them are supporting the church of Christ. Some of them are advisors. Some of them are converting souls. Praise the living God. If God has given you to be converting souls, to be bringing souls closer to Him, and you neglected it, which means you are neglecting Christ and God who has led you. Focus over what you have been given to. In the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 12, St. Paul was analyzing about the gifts. We have different gifts. And all these gifts come together to glorify and promote the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. so that we build that holy temple of God at the last day. Praise and thank God. As a child of God, we are celebrating about the birth of Christ, which is still due. In a few weeks or 2 weeks' time, maybe the whole world will gather together to celebrate. But it is important for you to understand what Christ means to this world. Christ means salvation to this world. And he has laid that foundation for believers to follow up with that foundation. Praise and thank God. If you don't mind, still turn with me to the book of John, chapter 3. I'm reading from verse 15. If you are there, say amen. And he says, now whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Amen. Amen. And the scripture says, Christ says, whosoever that believe in him, referring back to that same word of Isaiah 28 verse 16, that says, this is a trusted cornerstone, a trusted foundation, that whosoever that goes into this foundation must be saved. And man, Christ is talking to I and you. He said, whosoever that believe in him will not perish. This is the importance of Christ to come to this earth. This is the importance of Christianity. Praise the living God. Amen. If we finish all we are doing on earth and we are not being saved at the last day, automatically all we did here is in vain. But it will be preferable for I and you to be saved at the last day. Going into the kingdom of God will last for eternity according to the scripture. It is what lasts for eternity. But our life on earth here is just temporary. It's for a short period of time. It will not take too long. Praise the living God. Amen. Still turn with me, please, to the book of Ephesians to see how Ephesians analyze our Lord Jesus Christ. Ephesians chapter 2. I'm reading from verse 20. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
And he says, and I built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself, being the chief cornerstone. Amen.
Amen.
And the scripture continues analyzing our Christ as the chief cornerstone, who came into this life to become the chief cornerstone of our faith and belief in God. And he says, by this cornerstone, the whole apostles of old, the whole disciples of Christ, the whole prophets of Christ, they built up their own foundation from the same foundation of our Lord Jesus Christ. Any man that is building a different foundation today is not taking the right way. Praise the living God. Any church that believes in something else that is not of this foundation that has been led by Christ, with the prophets, they follows it. The apostles, they follows it. And all the true children of God followed it in their days. I'm encouraging you to follow it as well. And whatsoever you have been gifted by God, try to deposit it as well. Praise the living God.
Amen.
There is no way God will take, we accept you without your good job. Whatsoever you are doing for God in the house of God, out of the house of God, it is highly valued by the Most High God. Forget about anything you are seeing in the churches or in our community. Whom we are doing the good work for is our Most High God, who has made us in his image. If truly you need the salvation of God, I quite acknowledge that in the house of God, some of us might be filled with cold-mindedness. Some of us might be here to tempt the true children of God. When I was reading from the book of Job chapter 1, I come to realize why so many things have been wrong in the churches of Christ. And Job chapter 1 says, when the children of God gathered to praise and sacrifice unto their God, Satan came in there. Praise the living God.
Yeah.
And when God asked him, what are you doing here? He said, it is his job to continue combing the whole world. And today we see that same Satan in the house of God, demoralizing the children of God, discouraging the children of God. This is why we see people struggling and tussling for power in the house of God. But in the recess, we don't need to tussle and hustle for power in the house of God. Because if we are doing whatsoever we are doing to God wholeheartedly, what is the benefit of fighting one another? Praise and thank God.
Amen.
And verse 21 says, in whom all the building fitly framed together grows unto an holy temple in the Lord. Praise and thank God.
Amen.
What we are doing is spiritual. Christianity is not carnal. Our assembly to continue from the foundation our Lord Jesus Christ have laid, it will end up to a perfect holy temple. It's not talking about the physical temple we are seeing today on earth, but about the spiritual temple of God at the last day. That the children of God that we are saved, we assemble to praise God. When I was reading from the book of Revelation, I come to realize that at the end of the day, when Christ will come and take his holy children, and the scripture says, the children of God will gather before God in the kingdom of God to continue praising God day and night, all the days of our life. Praise the living God.
Amen.
This is the basic goal of a child of God. Every child of God, his basic goal is to make it at the last day, so that the foundation that Christ has laid will not be in vain for I and you. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Stay tuned with me to the book of Luke, our Bible text for today. Luke chapter 6. I'm reading from verse 47. If you are here, say amen.
Amen.
Whosoever cometh to me and heareth my sayings and dwell there, I will show you to whom he is like. Amen.
Amen.
As I have been telling the children of God and churches of Christ, coming to the church is one. Hearing the word of God is another part of it. But the most important part of it is to do the will of God and the commandments of God. This is the biggest part of following God. Not about what we are saying. When you finish saying it and you did not keep to what you are saying, I told you last week, any preacher who is preaching this good news, news of repentance, news of salvation, and he's not keeping to what he's saying, dear brother, don't listen to such preacher. Such person is not godly. Praise the living God. The book of 1 Timothy says, before you will teach in the church of Christ, you must examine yourself. You must have the quality. A drunkard cannot come and start telling you about drinking. Don't drink, that is a sin. It is not done. Praise the living God. And the scripture is telling us, whosoever that is listening to the word of God and keeping to those things that he has heard, Christ said, I will show you what that person looks like. And for verse 48 says, he is like a man who built a house and dig deep and laid the foundation upon a rock. And when the floods arose, the stream beat vehemently upon the house and could not shake it, for it was founded upon a rock. Amen?
Amen.
And Christ says, those that listen to this word, the message from God, the perfect message we have from God is this scripture. Whosoever that listens to this word and keep to these commandments, it is not the commandments of man. The commandment is applicable even to the speaker, to the preacher. The commandment is applicable. When Paul was evangelizing throughout the whole world, he was keeping to what he's saying. If he's not keeping to what he's saying, nobody will listen to him. When Peter was evangelizing, he was keeping to what he's saying. And the scripture says, to those that kept to this word, they shall be like a building that was being built properly, which the foundation goes down to the earth, and the foundation became so solid that it can never be shaken. He says, when the flood comes, the building will not collapse. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And verse 49 says, but he that heareth and doeth not is like a man that without a foundation built an house upon the earth, against which the stream did beat vehemently, and immediately it fell, and the ruin of that house was great. Amen.
Amen.
The importance of keeping the word of God. As I keep encouraging believers, we are walking towards perfection. St. Paul says it's not like he has achieved the goal, but he continues working towards perfection to achieve his goal. Our goal is salvation. And that was what Christ had bring into this earth for the children of God. And the scripture says, to those that listen and keep to the commandments of this God, who has made you in his image, they shall be like a solid building that will never collapse. But those that are not listening to the saying of the Holy Ghost, they shall be like a building without foundation, which will collapse easily. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Among the children of God, perhaps maybe over 90% comes to the church, but they are not keeping to the instructions of God. They are not listening to the commandments of God. They are not keeping to what we are reading. They are not keeping to what we are saying. And some of the preachers still preach without keeping to what they are saying. Praise the living God.
Yeah.
When I was doing my house fellowship yesterday, I was with young people. And the whole of them, what they are complaining is what they have been seeing, the failures and disappointments in Christianity among the ministers and pastors. But I told you last week that in as much as judgment is personal, it's individual, it is not collectively. You don't need to look unto those people. They shall be judged as well. Christ says those builders that build without foundation, their building will collapse. But those that decided to follow Christ diligently, to keep to the commandments of God, they will be like that solid building that will never shake. Praise the living God.
Amen.
To continue with our message, please turn with me to the book of John chapter 4. John chapter 4, I'm reading from verse 41. And 41 says, and many more believe because of his word. 42. And said unto the woman, now we believe, not because of thy saying, for we have heard him ourselves, and know that this is indeed the Christ, the Savior of the world. Amen?
Amen.
Who came to save the world is Christ Jesus, not any other power. And when the Samaritans, when they encountered Christ, they believed him by hearing his word, by seeing his way of living. They believed that truly this is the Son of God. And they come together to say he's the Savior of the world. If Christ is the Savior of the world and we, the children of God, are not honoring the great privilege that God has given unto us to send forth his Son, to make a proper way for the children of God, it will be disastrous at the last day for I and you. Except we start to follow God in the right way, start to believe him. Don't believe any other power. Don't believe any other man. But believe Christ Jesus, who has came into this earth. The book of Luke chapter 2 says, the angels descended. Because of the presence of Christ on earth, they descended. And now they said to the world, a great joy of good tidings have come upon this earth. Something great of joy. Christ is something of joy to this earth. Without Christ, we have no hope of salvation. Perhaps we continue struggling like the people of the old, that most of them perished without the intervention of the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. But today, the grace has been given to I and you, to great and small, for us to join up. Praise the living God.
Amen.
There is no way you can celebrate properly without understanding the basic purpose of our Lord Jesus Christ on earth. Amen.
Amen.
Slip on with me, please, to the book of Peter. To continue and to conclude our message, 2 Peter chapter 3, I'm reading from verse 17. If you are there, say amen. Amen. And verse 17 says, ye therefore, beloved, see ye not these things before, beware lest ye also be led away with the error of the wicked. Fall from your own steadfastness. Amen.
Amen.
Most of us that decided to do good work because of Christ, most people that decided to follow God because of the salvation of the last day, and the scripture is encouraging I and you. It says, be careful. Be careful to continue with your faith. Be careful to continue with the God that you are worshiping. Understand what you are chasing in the first place. And it says, because of the wickedness of the wicked people in the house of God, don't allow yourself to fall apart from your faith. Praise the living God.
Amen.
Because they knew very well wicked people will be in the house of God. And these wicked people might be anybody. It might be the leaders of our Christianity today. And the scripture says, be careful, beware of such people that weakens the faith of the people of God, so that we not fall apart from the race that you have started with Christ. Praise the living God. Anything you are doing and you know truly that you are doing it for the sake of this gospel, you are doing it for the sake of your last day, the scripture says, please continue. Be steadfast with that thing you are doing. The good services you are giving to God is part of your own salvation. You are building your home for the last day. No matter what you are doing, as I told you earlier, are you just a member? Perhaps you have some commitments with God. Your job might be to bring people for God. That's all. Perhaps you are a peacemaker in the house of God, just to continue making peace among the children of God. Don't forsake that peacemaking and start struggling for prophecy. Perhaps your gift is to be an usher in the house of God. Don't forfeit it and start struggling for speaking in tongue. Perhaps God has bring you to support the church of God and the poor financially. Don't forfeit it and start struggling to be a pastor. Praise the living God.
Amen.
The gift of God differs to each and every one of us. And when your job is perfect before God, the scripture says at the last day, you shall make it with Christ. And when you decided to forsake Christ because of evil people, when Job was sacrificing with his children to the living God, when Satan came in, they did not deserve that sacrifice to God. They did not stop worshiping their God whom they have assembled to worship. Praise the living God.
Amen.
But they continue with what they are doing to the very end. And Satan says his job is to continue going through and through the whole world, tempting the children of God, bringing the children of God down. But don't allow that to happen to you. Praise the living God.
Amen.
And verse 18 says, that grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be glory both now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the living God.
Amen.
The scripture is encouraging you. Continue growing in Christ. Continue valuing your salvation. Continue valuing that Christ who has come for your sake. So that at the last day, we all will gather before our Most High God. And to be with God for eternity. The salvation of mankind is the most important thing to God. And that was why he gave his son. He sent him to come into this world to lay that proper foundation. As scripture has told us that no any other foundation will be greater than the foundation that Christ has laid. I'm encouraging you, child of God. No matter what you are passing through, continue with your faith. No matter what you are yet to pass through, continue with your faith. No matter the endeavor of Satan to pull you down, don't allow that to happen. May God bless you.
Amen.
May God keep you.
Amen.
May God strengthen you.
Amen.
In all you are struggling, may the Lord be with you.
Amen.
No matter where you are and what you are passing through, may our God see you through and bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.